over you. May that curse come over you and prove over you and separate you for the work of the ministry.
Declare on you right now that I'm called as the Lord God Almighty, the Redeemer, the Lord our Savior Jesus has called and separated you to do His work in this church, the Church of Pentecost. And declare that call over you, the call into the office of the pastor of your life right now. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Everybody knows him, you know him, huh?
Yes.
Alright. A Apostle Marciano. It may be here, but you may not know him. Yeah, he's had his ministry at that year. But you have one in Sanya, I don't know the places. He said, okay, I don't want to be a place. So he's there, he has admired our setup, our group, this thing, and they want to meet us. So we can give him a chance to come and share his testimony with us. God bless him.
Praise the Lord. I give you thanks and praise.
Everybody thank you for
and I want to bless the Lord for Apostle Victor Mendy. Put us together for Jesus. Ezekiel 22:30 says, I've been seeking for a man. And I want to tell you, people of God, God is seeking for men in the Gambia. Makatushaka Labashia. He's seeking for men in the Gambia. And anyone that God catch, the Lord tell me to share something when I came in. I was driving to my church this morning and God said, turn back and go to church of Pentecost for that ordination. Although Alvaro is my brother in the village. And I said, okay, I had a faith, but I'll pray because I just got the program for that. Today is my first time to enter the West building and I'm passing Ghana Town. I only crusade in Ghana Town before, but I had never entered the West church. And as I was just coming, God tell me to share with you. God is seeking for a man in the Gambia who is standing with him. And God is telling me to share with you that is interested on the young man's views. No. In one thing. But God is telling me to share with you that there is a starving in the church. Some old prophets are there to starve the young boys. God showed me the day before yesterday, I was in the prayer for Alvaro and they got to show some certain things. Hallelujah. Please, God is telling me to share with you that whoever that is starved to starve a young minister in his church, count your days. God will take you off. God will take you off. He's so to me and so to me clearly, not just like in a dream form. So, let's encourage the young ones that is in the Gambia. Raise them up, build them up, show them, encourage them. That is what God tell me to share with you. Even as I come, I was battling with that. I don't, the Bible said the spirit of a prophet is so great because I'm not saying, I have to make sure that I control myself. I said, God, if it be you, let me give you this platform to share with people. Praise the Lord. So please, whoever that had that in mind, I don't, sometimes I call people to the gathering and say that I'm a bad prophet or whatever. But this one, thank God, our bishop here, our apostle here said that if you have a private talk and public talk, it's in the spirit. Praise the Lord. When he said this, I said, God, you are not speaking through the man. Praise the Lord. So that's what I want to share with you. Don't stop anybody in the church. Let's leave that criticism of a thing and start with this one. You know, the Bible, sometimes people are going to say, because I can speak English, this one can speak this one. No, the Bible says, you stop yourself approved unto who? Is this unto men or unto God? Unto God. You must prove your body unto God. Hallelujah. I want to bless the Lord. Amen. Amen. There is someone here among his ministers. God is telling them to pray because there is an attack on your waist. You are feeling pain on your waist. There is an attack on your waist. You are struggling with your waist pain. And the Lord healed you as purpose, ministering was saying that there is one of us that began to see that the pain is subsiding down, trying to make that pass. But continue to pray that pain, before you leave this building, the pain will disappear. I said, the pain will disappear. Jesus' name. Now, don't need one more time. Let me just go like that. Can I have permission, sir? When I came in, I looked unto you, I told us to be moved. I looked this thing in the feet. Yeah. I looked this thing. I don't know you much. And not to say I don't know. But God is telling me to share with you that I've seen you in Holland. Holland. I don't know what to do with Holland or whatever. I know we have traveled to that, but God wants to take you to a place of God's honor. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah. And this related to coffee. Without anybody called coffee. Without anybody called coffee. Among your, I didn't say your brothers and sisters. And you have coffee. Who's coffee? Yes, I do. What is he doing? You don't know. Men of God, I want us to pray for this young man that what God has created to be on earth will fulfill it. May the Lord bless you, brother. I don't know you, but may the Lord bless you. May the Lord take you to that mission that you showed me. In the name of Jesus. I say in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless your plans. As you just humble yourself, the Lord will take you far. In Jesus' mighty name, any power that is against the plan of God and the will of God in your life, wanted to break you, to break to the white man's message, I break that power. Under the grace of Apostle Victor here, give me the platform to share. I pray for you that you shall go to that nation and be a blessing to the people of God in the name of Jesus. May you be a kingdom financer under Pentecost and all some of the churches around that you know in the name of Jesus. Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. I love Church of Pentecost and I have good friends there like Apostle Vito and Pastor Alvaro and Pastor Alvaro and the rest of them. And even the apostle over there. I love Church of Pentecost and keep doing the work. Let's pray. Let us pray about our medicine. Say this one is a Ghana, this one is a Manjago. Let this one not come for a particular tribe. It come for all. That's why in the cross he said, it is finished. It is a finish of the Ghana, problem of Manjago. He said, it is finished. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, it is finished. Look at your brother and say, it is finished. Tell somebody, it is finished. I pray for you that every trouble that you come with, by the time you want to leave this building, that problem will be far away from you in the name of Jesus.
can never better than be saying the name of Jesus. You shall fulfill what God has created in this earth to be in the name of Jesus. Jesus, let me pray. Thank you, Father, because I've done it.
They are passing the main road. Right, they are holding their generals. So usher them inside, please. Yeah. Then I began to search.
I was going from one church to the other, And then one time, I think in 1999, God spoke to me sharply, and he said, go to the church of Pentecost. That time, your headquarters was around, is it Old Osman? Pakistan. So I went, first of all, I went to the Redeemed Christian Church, and I asked the pastor, Church of Pentecost, he said, this is not the Church of Pentecost. That man was faithful to me, and he directed me. So the man I met then, I could not remember his name. So I told him what I had in mind, and he prayed for me. After that, I became hungrier. So I thought God was calling me to be a priest. Then I entered into the seminary. I was there, and then the way they do their things, it's like the Spirit of God does not direct me there. One day I accompanied, and then they reported me to our spiritual director. So they thought he was going to reprimand me, but when I went, he asked me, and I told him where I was led, because in the seminary, every week you have to turn to lead that apostle. So when I was leading in the Pentecostal charismatic way, and they said, stop, this is not the way we do it. So our director, the director then stopped me. So when I went to a spiritual director, he said, no, here God has said to me, God leads you that way, move. Then we pray. And we asked God to talk to the director of the seminary. So the following day, he called us all, and to my surprise, he told them, the way God used me to lead, let everybody aspire for that. So I was moving with that, but one year, before I know, one day I was in the church, St. Charles. So in the midst of the service, I felt that there was this pattern that held me in, and then took me out of the church. And there was this concern upon me that if I wanted to go back, so it's like if you go into that. So I came out, and that was the end. I never went back. But with time, when I went for posting in Basel, I was coming. Then we had a communal week. You remember, then I was the moderator. Then we are there, that father was for the job. So he saw the way I was moving, and he called me and he said, my son, I would like you to locate a church whereby you manifest your call. If you abide here, we will give it because we do not understand. Then I asked him, which church would you advise me as a son to go? He said, go to the Church of Pentecost. So that is how I found my way in the Church of Pentecost. So as time goes on up late, persecution were coming, people were saying a lot of things about me, and I went to God. I said, Father, what about the ordination? A lot of things have been said concerning me. You know what God said? He looked at me and he smiled. He said, forget about what people have said, I've called you. So I want to glorify the name of the Lord. Here we are by the grace of God. I am the worst sinner on the planet Earth, but the difference is Jesus loves me and he died for me. And he made me who he wants me to be. And that is who I am today. So may the Lord's name be glorified.
Amen. I'm thankful for today because today marks another chapter in my life. And God has been grateful. All of us, before you come to the call, God has to take you from somewhere to put you to somewhere. And as a young man, even when they read my profile, I have a strong passion for academy. And it has been one of the factors that has been delaying me to give my final consent concerning ministry. Amen. Even in Nigeria, when I finished my senior secondary, by that time, before he went to Ghana for the 5 years, that's our dad, the apostle, he was a Hindu in those area. But I told you, no. I want to learn. Amen. And the one important thing, I was baptized in the Church of Pentecost before 2000, that is around 1999. But as time goes on, the church, we are not coming for fellowship regularly, so we went back to the world. And as I went back to the world, I find myself in New Life Church. From New Life, I find myself in New Ministry. Before finally, I could come back to the church that baptized me. Praise the Lord. And then the same church that happened to baptize me as a young man, God called me as a minister of the gospel. And I believe it's not by surprise, because I was seeing it coming. And there was also some dreams that God gave me personally in confirmation. One of the dreams I have less than a month, God showed me was in the congregation. He said, I gave you every gift and all the things, but I did not give you the pulpit, that is this place. He said, this time you do not have it yet. And I believe today is the day that God has confirmed it. Yes. So my prayer is for the pulpit to have fire. Yes, a pulpit without the fire, it won't do anything. And that's what God has called me for. Pride will not cause my gift to be damped down. And the members also, I also want to challenge us, pray for us, especially with you people who are coming up. We are just stepping. We need people to hold us so that we can anchor and stand properly. So I believe our daddy and those who have been in ministry before us, they have been great inspiration. I always tell them I did not come to the ministry to look for position. I came to serve God. Whatever will happen, title and whatever, let them come later. But my sole aim is to preach Christ and be crucified. I believe after having Christ, every other thing is secondary. And sometimes when you see me cry, I always remember my mother. I wish a day like this. My mom.
Now, shall we clap on to the Lord? Shall we clap on to the Lord? The Lord God the ruler, who saw you guys and has called you to accomplish his purpose in your life. Amen. We want to thank God for how far he's brought us, and that we will soon go. And we are calling the secretary to give us an announcement.
I just wanted to talk about the mother.
Pastor Moses, about his crying. Mother is not for you. Mother. He's not crying for the. He said, my mother should be blessed. My mother. Mother is very important. Everybody is crying. I felt like I should cry. But my mother is still alive. My mother is there. But you see, mother. Mother. Mama, God bless you. Our mother there. God bless you. God bless you, my mother.
He will never fail. I will hang on him. I will hang on him. He has promised he will never fail. He faithful. He forever on. He faithful.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Please let's listen to this announcement. The National has instituted Operation One Member, One Soul Project. Hallelujah. We expect to have 100 souls by the end of the year. Hallelujah. So each and every member is going to pray and have this or a target to win one soul. And there's going to be a reward. Though as we target one member, one soul, some people will target 5, 10 or more.